Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, thank you for the committee for the opportunity to present my research study in this conference. Let me introduce myself and my team. I am Ferdi Putri Logensa. In this research, I was supported by my lecturer, are Mrs. Nandaria, Mrs. Mujirahayu, Mr. Bambang Pujiasmanto, Mr. Sutarno, Mrs. Priyatun, and Mr. Suharyana. In this opportunity, I would like to present my article about the quality and performance of three-strain black rice from gamma ray irradiation. First of all, the background of my research is black rice campur iring is one of the local Indonesian rice variety that contains high anthocyanin. Anthocyanin are antioxidant compounds that have the potential to increase the body's resistance to disease. Ternawan and Melayani said that the protein content of black rice is lower than white rice, but higher than red rice. Sombong et al. Said that black rice also has a high amylose content of 25.49% compared to other rice, so that causes the texture of rice become too dry. Based on this problem, there are several ways to solve the problem of black rice. One of the modern to improve the yield quality and reduce the weakness of black rice is by mutating and using gamma ray irradiation. The results was conducted from December 2019 until January 2021. Black rice cultivation was conducted in the Faculty of Agriculture Experiment Field located in Ijo Village, Tasikmadu District, Karanganyar Regency with upward of 157.6 meters above sea level. The quality of result was conducted in Chemik Pratama Laboratory, Jambidan Village, Banguntapan District, Bantul Regency, Special Region of Yogyakarta. The material used in this study were black rice campur ireng of M7 generation which were irradiated by gamma ray and control or without irradiation. The experiment used a different treatment of strain consisting of black rice campur ireng gamma ray irradiation result is strain X, strain 44, strain 51 and control or without irradiation as a comparison. Determination of result sample in the paddy field was used simple random sampling technique by selecting 30 plants per strain. Observation data were analyzed descriptively and qualitatively. Observation variables are anthocyanin content, amylose content, protein content, fat content, vigor and seed viability, organoleptic and seed pre-cup color. Next, result and discussion. According to Nandaria et al., the anthocyanin content is a very important chemical content to know because the higher anthocyanin content in black rice, so darker the color of the breakup. Table 1 showed that the highest anthocyanin content was found in the strain 44 at 75.11 ppm and the lowest anthocyanin content was found in control at 44.8 ppm. Based on the data obtained, the increase in the anthocyanin content in black rice caused by gamma ray irradiation is supported by Ramawati et al., which state that the dose of gamma ray irradiation in black rice campur ireng gave the effect of increasing anthocyanin levels compared to plant without irradiation or control. Second, amylose content can be seen at table 2, which show that the result of analysis of amylose content in black rice campur ireng with gamma ray irradiation were lower than plant without irradiation or control. The decrease in the amylose content of black rice due to gamma ray irradiation was proven by research conducted by Masruro et al., which said that gamma ray irradiation treatment caused a decrease in amylose content from 14.41% to 12.84%. Third, protein content can be seen at table 3, which show that the dose of gamma ray irradiation increased the protein content of black rice. Putri said that the irradiation treatment on black rice campur ireng caused a significant increase in protein content and increased with increasing irradiation dose. The protein content of the strain 44 was 0.3% lower than the control. One of the factors causing the decrease in protein level is genetic strain. This is stated by Baye et al. That the chemical composition of seeds such as protein and lipids is more influenced by genetic trial. Next, Fat contact can be seen at table 4. It shows that the dose of gamma ray irradiation can affect the fat content of black rice. This is evidence in the research of Istanti that the application of gamma ray irradiation was able to increase the fat content of black rice from 2.5% to 2.6%. Next, figure and seed viability can be seen at table 5, which show that the effect on germination power and germination speed due to gamma ray irradiation treatment. The increase in the value of germination power and speed of black rice jumbo ireng result from gamma ray irradiation is in accordance with research Ramamila and Saputra, which conclude that the dose of gamma ray irradiation gives the effect of increasing percentage compared to plants without a dose of gamma ray irradiation. Next, organoleptic can be seen at table 6, which show that the highest average organoleptic scoring result are found in the strain 44 of 3.53. Cristantini et al. State that the higher anthocyanin content value, so the more purple or black the color of rice. Luna et al. State that the rice with low amylose content is soft and sticky texture. Will rice with high amylose content then dry texture. And the last, seed pre-cup color can be seen at table 7 and figure 1, which show that the seed pre-cup color of the strain more black than control. The large of number scoring than the dark seed pre-cup color, so it can be known that the strain 44 has a dark color. This is supported by Rahmawati et al. In her research that strain 44 has a dark pre-cup color than to other strain, A strain 51 and control. Next, conclusion. The quality and performance of the result of the three strain black rice jumbo ireng generation M7 gamma ray irradiation results so better compared to strain without gamma ray irradiation or control. This is reference there are used to make this presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.